our project again with a new concept, how to maintain the session and how to create a logout concept. That is, we have to design a logout option in our web project. So let's start it. So in the last video, what we have done is, I'll give you a brief summary. So here we have extracted the username and password from the your login panel, that is the username and password given by the user, and we will match with the username and password in the database, and if it is matched, then we have incremented the counter and we will print that particular user is valid or not. Okay, so now we have to design a concept in which we are going to do, like, we have to redirect it to a new page. Suppose if user has given the right credential, that is username and password, then it will be redirected to a profile page. Okay, so now we will design our concept using the session. So first we'll create a new page, a JSP page whose name is profile.jsp. So just finish it. Okay, so this is the profile.jsp page in which the profile is loaded. Okay, so how can we redirect it to this page if a username and password is correct? So just come to the login.jsp code again. Okay, so here we will write that is C equals to 1, that is if user is valid, then we have a response implicit object, response dot send redirect. Okay, and the URL we have to provide here is profile.jsp. okay, in else part we will giving the message that invalid user. So if a user is giving the correct credentials, then it will be redirected to the profile.jsp. But what about the username and the password? So here we have to implement the concept of session. So suppose if this particular username and password is correct, so we have to implement two things. First, we will increment the counter variable and we will store these two, username and the password, in the session variable. So session dot set attribute, here we have to define the name of the variable. So here we have write username and a value. So value is available in the UN here, and we have to set another attribute, session dot set attribute, then we have password, and it will be stored in the PD. So now we have set our uname and pass, these are the name of the session variables, and it will contain the UN and PD value, that is it will be extracted from the HTML page. So these are the way you can extract it and verify it from the database, that these username and password is available in the database, and if it is match, then first we will increment it and then we will set the session attribute, uname and password. Then we have the logic to redirect. Then if C equals to 1, that means this code have been executed at least once. Okay, so it will be redirected to the response dot send redirect. With the help, we can redirect it to the profile.jsp. So in profile.jsp, we will retrieve all the details with the help of these two session variables. Okay, so first we will print these two values. So suppose here we want to know, so first we will want to extract these two values. So here we will declare two variables, UN, uname, past. Okay, so these are two string variables we have declared. So in uname we want to extract it. So session dot get attribute. Okay, so here we have to give the name of the session variable what we have declared. So let's check it. So we have created a session variable uname and a second session variable is pass. So here we will give uname. Okay, we have to typecast it to the string. Now, okay, next we have a new pass w. Again, we have to do the same thing, typecasting, then session dot get attribute. So here we have a session variable pass. Okay, so now we have these two things in our profile. Suppose we want to load the whole profile. So on the basis of these two values, we will also load the whole profile. Okay, very easily we can do that. We can have the same connectivity code. We will extract the username, password and email. So here we have only three fields. Okay, just check in the database, in phpMyAdmin. We have the database UGI, and in UGI we have a table name as login. So in this particular table we have user, pass and email ID. Suppose we have more information like father's name, date of birth, so we can load the whole profile in this page. Okay, we will design this concept, but right now we are only focus on to describe only display the these two, username and password. Okay, so we will write out dot print ln, and here we will give a message welcome uname. Okay, we will not show the password in this page because the password is a very secured thing. So as per security reason, we will not display any password in profile page. So this particular message, that is username, will appear on this page. And again, we have to do some HTML code. Okay, for regarding this logout. Okay, so first we will execute this code and check whether this is running or not. So for that we need two information, that is user and password. So we have a username abhi123 and a password is abhi123. So we have executed this code and do the login. Okay, so here we will give abhi123 and the password is same, abhi123. So when we click on the login, it will be redirected to the profile.gsp. Okay, so here you'll see that welcome abhi123, that is, this is the name of the username is displayed here and the page is profile.jsp. okay, so we have extracted the value from the session variable, and you know that session is active for a particular time. So if you want to delete these values, that is username and password, from this particular page, so we have to design a logout page. Okay, so that the values that we have set in the session attribute, we have to remove these. Okay, so suppose I am giving a hyperlink as logout.jsp and the option here we will give logout. Okay, so here we have a hyperlink. When we click on logout, it will be redirected to the logout.jsp. so this time we have a hyperlink also. This, so suppose we have designed a page and we will have this logout button on a page profile.jsp. we will have to integrate this particular code. So particular this thing what we have to do is here. So here we have a logout button. Okay, So we want to design a logout option for that. So first we will have a page logout.jsp. So again we will create a new page, a JSP page. Name of the page is logout. Okay, just finish it. So here we have a logout page, and here we have to do a design a logic. It's a very simple logic. We have to just invalidate and remove a session variable. So here we have a session dot invalidate. Okay, it will invalidate, or more you can do session dot set attribute. So we have union and value, you can here give 0. So you can also set attribute again in the same attribute, you can have a 0. Okay, but you don't need to do this because you have already invalidated this. So all the variable have already been gone. That means the value have been destroyed, all the session value variable have been destroyed. And after that, suppose we have click on the logout button, it will clear the session variables, it will invalidate all the variables. Okay, it will clear the session attribute values, then it will be redirected to a home page. So response dot send redirect, and name of the home page is index.html. okay, so in this way I have created a option for logout. Okay, so what will happen if you click on the logout option, it will be then redirected to the logout.jsp page. Here the session variables are now have been destroyed and invalidated here first, and then it will be redirected to the index.html page. That is, you will be redirected to the login page. So now we are going to execute this with a sequence. Okay, so we have a login ID. Again, we have a login ID abhi123, and the password is abhi123. Login it. Then we will redirect it to the profile.jsp, and we have a welcome message also. Now, if I will click on logout button, you'll see that we will redirect it to a index.html. Okay, so when you click on the login button, so you have to enter the credential again, and now your session have been destroyed, your session variables have been destroyed. Okay, so in this way we will create our logout page. So we have a coding for this JSP for logout page. In profile, with the help of username and password, you can also load the whole page. Okay, I will design this concept in next video, how to load your particular profile, whole profile. Here we have a username and password from the session variable, and with these session variable we can load the whole profile also, and we can also update it. Okay, so in next video I am going to tell you how to update your information, how to update your information, how to delete your profile. Suppose if any user want to delete his profile, so how can you do this? Okay, and some designing also regarding HTML and all. So in next video I'm going to tell you these concepts. Okay, so that's all for this video. Thank you.